Hello, welcome back to the Desk Corner and welcome to a new video. In today's video, I'm actually going to be packing, and that's because I'm going on a little road trip to my aunt's ranch a couple hours up north in my state, and I'm really excited to go. I've pre-filmed a few videos for you guys that I can work on and get up while I'm over there, and I'm also going to bring some art supplies and maybe my filming equipment and see what I can do while I'm up there. So I thought it would be fun to show you guys what I'm packing, art supply wise, of course. And I'm not really sure what I'm packing, so this is going to be a fun little adventure of a video. So without further ado, let's get to packing because I've only got about 2 days now. So I'm kind of just winging it for this video because I'm really not sure what I'm going to pack. I do know for sure that I'm going to pack my watercolor pencils because they just fit so nicely in this little pouch, which is so cute and compact. And I've got my 60 set of Faber-Castell watercolor pencils here, and I also have, hold on, there's a water brush in here as well, which I need to fill up. And it holds a lot of water, so that's why I'm packing this water brush as opposed to this other one, which is slightly smaller. I want to get into using my watercolor pencils a little more, and this is a perfect way, I think, for me to do so. So I'm bringing these for sure. So watercolor pencils are great to use on the go. Also, fineliners are great to use on the go as well. So I'm going to pack some fineliners. I'm not entirely sure which ones I want to bring. I think I don't really need a huge variety of sizes. I think I'm going to go with 5. Let's see. This is one that I like to use for writing. So I'm going to bring this one by Faber-Castell. So I've got a sepia, a red, and I want to bring this black one. I don't really need the really fine tip ones, so I'm not going to bring too many of those. I'm going to bring a black Copic marker, you know, just in case I want to fill in some larger areas. So I'm just going to bring one of those. Well, I only have one Copic marker as it is. 3 sizes of black fineliners, 3 sizes of sepia, and a red one as well, just for fun. And you know, I sometimes like to do writing and things like that too, so these are not just for artwork. And I think this is probably a good amount of fineliners. I won't need anything more than that. So I'm not sure what bag I'm going to pack everything in. I'm just gonna put these to the side right now. I think I'm gonna throw in a gel pen. Guys, I don't know if I should throw in my watercolors because I already have my watercolor pencils. And I don't have any small set of watercolors. I have my Cotmans, and look, my Cotmans have less colors, but they're pretty much the same size as the Senliers, and this is like a 48 set. So technically this is pretty compact. I'm just afraid to like bring it with me. I don't want anything to happen to it. So I don't think I'm gonna bring my watercolors. I think I'm just going to use my watercolor pencils while I'm there. I just realized I have this 12 set of Faber-Castell watercolor pencils that I don't even really use because I have the full 60 set, and this was the one I bought to try. So, since these pencils are hardly really used at all, there's just a couple of like marks on the tin, I wonder if I should include this as part of a giveaway here. I know it's only 12 colors, but it feels like kind of a waste if they just sit in my drawer, you know? So I don't know, maybe when I get back I'll do some sort of giveaway. I do need to clean out my desk and figure out if there's other art supplies that I could include in a giveaway as well, but here is one of them. Comment down below if you'd be interested in me doing a giveaway or something like that in the near future. Guys, here's where I'm stumped. I don't know what pencils I want to bring. I don't think I want to bring too many like charcoal pencils or anything that's going to be too messy because this is travel stuff. We want to avoid a mess. That's the biggest thing here. We want to make this very easy. I don't think there's a point of me keeping my Lumigraph black in this tin because it's less likely that I'll use it. So I think I'm just going to stick it in with all my other charcoal and carbon pencils, but I'll keep the tin because the tin is just really cute. Guys, I just found this really, really cute little backpack, and I usually use these for hiking. I have another one as well. This is so cute, and I can actually just stick my art stuff in here, and it has this little pouch, so I'm gonna put some tape and some pencil sharpeners, erasers. I'll even stick in this pencil sharpener, which I really like to use as well, and anything else that I might need is gonna go in here. And then the best part about that is I also have room to put in a little sketchbook, so I think what I'm gonna do is head to Michael's tomorrow when I'm going to do some errands, pre-trip errands, and I'm gonna get probably a little mixed media sketchbook because I don't have one of those. So that is what I'm going to do. I'm gonna see if I can fit anything else. I was able to fit my water-soluble graphite in here, and I'm gonna see if I can fit some more unnecessary pencils that I don't need to bring because we all know how much fun that is. Perfect, I can fit everything. And I still have room for a sketch pad. And I've also got my planner here and cute little journal I'd like to bring with me as well. And if this doesn't fit in here, that's okay. But I was hoping, let's see, is this too close for you guys to see? I just wanna see how that fits. Yep, it's really nice. I could still fit a sketchbook in there. I love JanSport. They just have the best backpacks and bags, and they just have so much room. I'll stick a couple of pens in there, just writing pens as well. I don't have a compact little ruler, which is kind of depressing. I've got a bendy one that might just fit in there fine. So because that was so chaotic, I thought I'll just show you guys what I ended up packing because that was just a disaster. I did pack most of it on camera, but I thought I would just show you guys how everything looks now. So I have got a couple of pens for writing in this little flap here. I've also got my sharpeners and erasers and some washi tape and a gel pen. So I don't know if I'm going to need washi tape, but it doesn't hurt to bring it anyways. So that's what I have in my little outside flap of this backpack. These are just great little backpacks. I recommend them for hiking and all sorts of things like that. So I just think these are really handy. So let me show you guys what's in here. Look how cute. I've got, as you can see, a lot of books, and these are not all art supplies. I ended up going to Michael's and getting a mixed media sketchbook. Now, usually I don't really like cans and paper all that much. However, I didn't really have enough time to put much time into looking for a little sketchbook, and I really needed one of these, and I wanted it to be mixed media. You could see I tested out fine liners on that side, and they don't show through. I wanted it to be mixed media since I am bringing watercolor pencils after all, and fine liners, as well as like charcoal and things like that. So I don't know how well this is going to do. It's just gonna be experimental. I'm most likely not going to fill up too much of this while I'm gone, but it will be fun to have something to just sketch for fun in. So that's just my little sketchbook that fits nicely in here. I've also got a book. I'm not really sure if this is actually the book I want to bring. This is a Shirley Jackson book. If you guys have seen Haunting of Hill House, that's based on her book as well. So I thought maybe I would bring something spooky to read with me, but I'm still not completely sure if this is the book I want. I showed you guys this bendy ruler that I'm gonna bring, you know, just because it's bendy, so it's easier to bring this one, just in case I might need a ruler. I've also got my little book light. This is kind of handy at night because I usually end up reading at night. You could also use it for writing, I guess. And then we've got the art supplies, which this is the same as what I showed you guys, but we'll just recap again. In here I've got my watercolor pencils, my black polychromos, the black Copic, and my water brush. And the black polychromos I end up needing no matter what I do, so thought I would just bring that one with me. And then in here I've got some extra things. I've got some water-soluble graphite, some giant graphite, fine liners, some charcoal, and some carbon pencils. I think the Mars Lumigraph Black are in here. I just want to get to know them better. I feel like now I have a lot of supplies that I don't know super well, and I want to get more acquainted with them, and I'd feel more comfortable using something like this where if I mess up or something, I'm not going to be super like upset about it. And I wouldn't be super upset about it if I messed up with a final like artwork piece or something, but that type of paper is way more expensive, and I spend a lot of time on those pieces, so I think this will be a little bit freeing to just use these pencils for fun and get acquainted with them. And I have a ton of pages to work with here, so I obviously am not worried. And all of that stuff fits into this tiny little JanSport. So yeah, that is what I'm bringing. I'm gonna go ahead and put everything back in here. See how nicely everything fits in there? It's all very compact. And I guess I'm good to go art supply wise. So as I said earlier, you guys, I do have some pre-filmed videos for you, and I'm going to do my best to film a few things while I'm up there. It's not going to be easy, and I'm not going to be able to work on a big piece, of course. I'm not even bringing anything like that. But I will try to get a little bit of footage while I'm there, so that way when I come back, I can put together more videos for you guys. So as always, thank you guys so much for watching today's video. I hope that you enjoyed it, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!